This free AI tool can generate real-time images and enhance your renders to make them realistic. Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today we'll be looking at this tool called Krea AI, which has some unique features, making it highly useful for architects and designers. I have been using these features for a while now and we'll walk through these features today. I'm Salman, an architect and illustrator. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon for notification. So let's get started. Now the first question that you might have is if this platform is free. This platform is indeed free to try, and you can try out all the basic features using this trial version. It comes with 3 minutes of rendering time, which makes it sufficient to try out all the features. I'll leave the link to the platform in the description of this video. This is what the homepage of Krea AI looks like, and it has a very simple interface. There are 3 main tools available in Krea AI, and those are real-time generation, image enhancer, and video generation. For this video, we'll focus more on real-time AI generation and the image enhancer. You can use all of these tools for free using the free version. We'll have to sign in to use these tools. Click the sign up option on top, and you can access it by creating an email ID or by using your Google account to log in. Let's start with the first tool, which is real-time image generation. We have an empty canvas right here, and the right side is where the AI images get generated. On the left side, we'll be using different tools to provide inputs for the AI images. On the bottom, we have a text box in which we'll be providing the text prompt to describe the image that we intend to create. On top, we have a slider called AI Strength, and this determines the creativity of AI that gets applied onto the inputs that we're providing. Let's start with the first tool on the top left side, which is text to image. This is pretty straightforward, and all we have to do is to type in a prompt and it gets generated immediately in the screen. As we see, the image generation is almost immediate, and it changes based on each word that we type in the text prompt. Let's type something along the lines of a modern museum in the style of Zaha Hadid and use the keywords such as curves, modern design, and glass. The images are generated instantly based on each word that we type. Instead of Zaha Hadid, let's type in Frank Gehry, and the image changes instantly. We can type in maybe Le Corbusier, and that is reflected in the image as well. We can add more details to the prompt by describing the day or night scene, adding people and water body in the front. Let's look at the different modes on the right side. We are currently working on this mode called photo, and we can also choose the next one called conceptual. This creates kind of a conceptual images which are not very realistic but still carries the concept that we're trying to create. We also have a CGI option which creates a kind of blender animation. The last one is the cartoon option, which has vibrant tones and a certain level of exaggeration. The HD option is only available on the paid plan. For conceptual architectural designs, we can either choose photo or concept. Right below, we have an option called Quick Enhance, and by choosing that, the image quality gets improved further. We can download the image from the next button below. The third button takes you to the Enhance tab, which we'll be looking at in detail in the next part of this video. On the bottom left, we have options to change the aspect ratio of the image generation. We can change it into horizontal, vertical, or square images. The image generation also changes based on the aspect ratio. The second option within the generate tool is called image to image. And as the name suggests, we can upload images to create AI generations. First, let's type in a prompt. And for this one, I'll be using the keywords a modern villa elevation in glass and wood, exterior design architecture, and so on. I've chosen the photo mode for this. And on the left side, we have options to add the shapes. Let's choose that and add a rectangular shape, and we can immediately notice that the canvas on the right side has taken inspiration from the rectangle and applied the text prompt to create the image. Let's add a few other shapes on the bottom and top, and these are immediately reflected on the canvas. Let's try adjusting the AI strength slider, and we can notice how gradually the shapes are reflected into the canvas. An AI strength of 0.8 kind of has a balance between the shapes and the image, and if we move the slider further, the AI adds its own creativity and moves away from the existing shapes. We can also select all the shapes as a group and move it around, and as we move the position, it gets reflected on the canvas as well. Let's delete the shapes and look at the next option called generate image. This is quite interesting because with this feature, we can actually generate an image on the left side with AI and blend in with the main prompt to create a new image. Let's type in a prompt for a wooden texture and resize it. And as you can see, the canvas blends the wooden texture on the left side with the main prompt on the bottom to create a new image. Similarly, we can type in any texture on the left side, and that will get transferred to the main canvas on the right side. We can adjust the AI strength to get the desired output. Let's download a few of these for later. From the next option on the left side, we can upload an image from the local drive. Like we saw previously, the canvas blends in the base image that we uploaded with the keyword prompts to create the image. We see that it kind of blends the character of the marble image and creates a building elevation with a white outlook. For instance, I've uploaded a villa elevation on the left side, and by adjusting the AI strength, we can create variations of the same reference image that we've uploaded. We can play around with the strength to create multiple outputs. Let's now clear the canvas, and by using the last option, we can actually sketch on the left side, and that will get reflected on the AI canvas. Let's try creating outlines of a villa elevation. We might have to adjust the prompts, AI strength, and also switch between the photo mode and the concept mode to look at different outputs. We also have the option to change the background of the canvas, and we can choose between photos in this toolbar. Let's select this sky image, and that transfers the style and environment into the canvas. There isn't right or wrong with whatever you're creating here, and it completely depends on your own preference. You can try choosing different background images, and each of these will be reflected into the main canvas. We can change the background as a plain solid color as well. And finally, I have picked this forest background and also adjust the prompts to create more depth in the image. Let's enhance it using the quick enhance and download the image. The next tool is called screen to image, and this can open a wide range of possibilities. I've created a new SketchUp file, and let's choose the window from this dialog box. Let's resize the tabs on the window, and inside the SketchUp file, I'm trying to make a very simple rectangular volume. Now, as we create the base model in SketchUp, it gets transferred as an AI image directly in Krea AI. Let's make sure to adjust the AI strength to not make it too away from the base model. Let's add a few more volumes on the SketchUp model, and we see that it's creating a very interesting conceptual design inside the canvas. We can also adjust the background images like we did previously, and that will reflect into the canvas as well. This can be highly helpful in the conceptual stage while you're brainstorming different ideas for your elevation designs. As we change the angle in SketchUp, the views also change inside the Krea canvas. We can also add a few textures around in case you want specific ideas for your project. Let's try the second tool, and this has been really useful for me in the past few months. Let's choose the Enhance option from the Krea homepage, and this is what the tool will look like. To begin with, let's upload one of the images that we previously generated using the other tool. Once uploaded, we have the settings on the right side. With the free version, we will only be able to upscale it by 2x. Turn on the Settings tab, and we have the prompt which is automatically generated inside the tool. We have options to change the AI strength, resemblance, and clarity. I usually leave the settings as it is, and let's go ahead and click Enhance. It usually takes about a minute or two based on your image. We have the output, and as you can see, this has done a great job in enhancing the clarity of the image. There are some great improvements in the textures of the image. We are only using the free version, and the quality that is created from this is quite outstanding. This is roughly how this tool works, and now let's try doing the same using this rendered image. This rendering right here is kind of flat, and it lacks a certain depth in the image. And importantly, we see these human figures and cutouts. These human figures usually do not appear too realistic, and that kind of affects the overall look of your rendering. Let's upload this image into Krea AI and click Enhance. In just a minute, we have the results, and you can see it for yourself, the improvement in the quality and the overall look of the image. Notice how the human figure looks more realistic and natural. There's also some amazing improvement with the textures on the furniture and on the other spaces. Here's a side-by-side comparison of both the images. Let's try looking at it once again with this rendered image of a boy with his dog. And quite obviously, it does not look too realistic. Let's upload it into Krea AI and see the magic. That is some fantastic result, and you won't really be able to say if it's a real image or an AI generated. This can be an amazing way to significantly improve the quality of your renders in a short span of time. Here is a side-by-side comparison. And finally, let's actually upload one of the renders that I made a few years ago using SketchUp and V-Ray. I mean, it did look like a good render at that point of time, but let's upload it into Krea AI and see what it does. That is some fantastic improvement on the rendered image. I didn't really work on the textures of the sofa, so they appear too flat on the rendering. Whereas on the Krea image, we can notice how detailed the textures look on the sofa. There's also an overall improvement on all the other textures like the wood, plants, and also these reflective vase surfaces. It has greatly improved the depth and shadows of the rendering as well. I also turned my illustrations from this into realistic images using Chrome AI and Krea AI. Comment down below if you'd like to see a process of this one. So that was it from the walkthrough of Krea AI. Personally, I think this has great potential to assist in design thinking and visualization. Comment down below what are your thoughts about this platform. You can follow me on Instagram and the handle is right here. I'll see you on the next one.